Well, first of all, I don't think that that's mean what you're saying. I may not have something like super sweet to say. My thought is, how bad do you want this?
Welcome to Keto on the Couch, episode 142.
I'm Rachel.
And I'm Joe.
And we are two crazy ketos.
And if you're new to our channel, welcome.
Yes, welcome. If you're new here, say hi down below.
Now here on Two Crazy Ketos, we do different things like recipe videos and we do product reviews. We talk about various keto topics. And then every Monday, we go live on Keto on the Couch. We just kind of talk about what's going on in our lives for the week.
You can find us in different social media platforms like Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter.
And we have a website, which is twocrazyketos.com. And that's where you're going to find all of our different recipes. Now, we do upload at least 5 new videos every single week. So make sure you subscribe to our channel.
And don't forget to hit the little bell icon. And that way, every single time we upload a new video, you'll be alerted to it. Happy Hanukkah for everybody celebrating
right.
It. So this is Monday and it starts Sunday evening. So we're taping this Saturday, so yes. It hasn't happened yet, but we don't want to miss the opportunity to wish everybody a happy Hanukkah.
Yeah. So yeah, like Rachel just said, we are taping this on Saturday. Normally this will be live, but when you're watching this, if you're watching it when we first premiere it, we will be driving for a family camping trip. And the original plan was to premiere it. And plans have changed because Rachel has to actually drive a separate car.
Yeah.
And so she's not going to be able to type and drive. Hopefully you can't type
Don't
and drive.
Don't ever type and drive.
So yeah, we're just going to put it up. We will go back to being live next week. We're really excited about that. But we're excited about a family camping trip because you know what? The boys are getting older. And, you know, how many more camping trips are you going to get with them?
Don't even say that. I'm going to start crying. A million billion. They will always want to camp with Mama Bear.
Now, just a reminder that we will not be doing any regular vlogs this week. Now, there are videos going up, including an episode of Keto Camping Fear Factor.
Don't worry, I have packed some Keto Camping Fear Factor food for our trip.
What? Why?
Well, talk about don't want to miss an opportunity. We got the kids and my mom. Why should we be the only ones tortured?
Anyway, make sure you subscribe to the channel and you hit that bell button so that you are notified when that video goes up. And we've got a couple of review videos, a couple of other vlogs going up. So you'll have content this week. And then next week, we'll be back to our daily or every other day vlogs.
I'm sorry, but I have some perfect keto, the Max Mallows things in my...
Before we started filming, I started eating one of these. And I've only had one of the chocolates.
And
I like
helped.
The peanut butter one. I think this is my new favorite flavor.
I like the chocolate. Yeah, it's really good.
Also, just a reminder, if you're watching this on Monday, when it does go live, it's Cyber Monday. And a lot of the keto companies are still having some sales going on. I know Keto Chow's got their sales going on. They actually got a couple flavors launching. So excited about that. Perfect Keto still has their sale going on. And this is the sale to stock up for
right.
with Perfect Keto.
Super cheap stuff.
When you get up to 50% off. As a matter of fact, as soon as we're done filming this, I'm gonna go transfer it over to the computer and then I'm gonna go edit.
Because they're like $1.50 a piece.
Well, I don't even think it's that much. So it breaks down to be $10 a box if you buy 6 items from Perfect Keto.
Oh my God.
And the Nola bars, $10. So that breaks down.
Cheap
There's
snacks.
8 in here. That's what is that? Like $1.10 or something like that? $1.15 a bar? That's cheaper than non-keto snacks that people eat.
Well, and this is what we'll bring with us on the camping trip because yep. Now we're no longer on beef, butter, bacon, and eggs.
I should have ordered them before the
well,
camping trip.
Well, I mean, because the kids eat them too.
Yeah.
I mean, because they loved Rice Krispie treats.
And I'd rather them eat that than regular Rice Krispie
well,
treats.
Well, it tastes exactly the same and I don't have to make anything.
Yeah.
Done dirty anything. I love it.
I learned something today. You'll actually see this on the vlog, but don't mix Zip Fizz with San Pellegrino in a blender bottle and close the lid.
Yeah.
Unless you're gonna like put a lot less water in there because it explodes.
This is a public service announcement.
Yeah.
But it tastes like a fancy pants drink though.
I like it with the San Pellegrino.
Yeah.
But I put it in that lid and it was like opening up a soda bottle on an airplane at 15,000 feet when you're sitting next to your wife.
Yes. Fortunately, I had walked away from him, or you know our track record, Joe would have soaked me with his liquid, because yes, every single time.
Okay, let's talk about Thanksgiving. We had a phenomenal Thanksgiving. So much fun. So much food. Michelle did an amazing job of preparing stuff. We brought the pork belly. The pork belly disappeared, you know, between having the burnt-end pork belly and the standard smoke it like a brisket pork belly. There was nothing left.
Well, and I have to say, props to our oldest son, the birthday boy. John Paul brought his, like, the game.
I was impressed.
That turkey. He smoked the turkey, and all of the YouTube videos that he watched paid off because it was perfection.
I was impressed because I've taught John Paul how to do a lot of things. I mean, I taught him how to do electrical work. He's actually an electrician. I taught him how to tile his house. He tiled his entire house. I've taught him how to do dry. He can do pretty much anything. I taught him how to cook, but I never taught him how to work on a grill.
Right.
But thanks to YouTube.
Yes.
He was able to learn how to smoke a turkey on the Pit Boss grill that we gave him. And I mean, it was just perfection.
You know what was really nice too, which we do all the time, but don't talk about it, is you're trying to keep everything warm at once. I mean, that was, you know, Michelle reminded me so much of my mom because she was like, it all has to be hot at the same time. And like, we're used to eating things kind of cold because we vlog and like you get to
talking. Some people more than others.
I know. I get a lot more hot food than he does, but because I've got a lot more hot air going on. But we use the smoker, like while it's still, you know, going, to just put the trays of food into the smoker to keep it hot and then just put it all out because it's got a big, you know, there's a lot of real estate in that smoker. So he was just putting pans of stuff to keep it warm and then bringing it inside. And I thought we do that a lot, but we don't show that a lot.
Yeah.
But it really helps.
Now, I did want to mention, speaking of Michelle, you know, Michelle is our daughter-in-law. We call her our daughter because she's like a daughter, right?
She's in now. She's stuck.
And Michelle is a CrossFit trainer.
Yeah.
And she looks phenomenal.
She's amazing.
But you took a picture next to her.
Yeah.
And I want you to be proud of yourself as well. Because looking at this picture, you guys are close to the same size. First of all,
is she not the prettiest girl ever?
You guys look like you could be sisters.
Well, thanks for that.
You certainly don't look like you're old enough to be her mom.
Well, thanks.
So you look great. Michelle looks great. It was nice, though. Even though it was different than what we're used to, you know, for Thanksgiving, you know, it was weird, like going to your child's house for the first time.
We felt very adult.
I did. But it was just nice to have the whole family together. So we just wanted to share a picture of, you know, everybody together. So this is everybody. So we have, you know, obviously me, Rachel, you have Anthony and Caleb in the back. That's our son, John Paul, which we don't really share many pictures because he is a little bit of a shy person.
Yeah.
And there's Michelle, and that is Michelle's parents.
How beautiful.
And it was just a great day to spend together as family.
Michelle has exactly how I felt across her shirt, thankful. I felt very, very thankful for the opportunity to be together. For all the all the boys under one roof.
Yeah.
I mean, whoever's roof it is, right? Like, I love that.
Make
so much.
Sure you guys, when that video comes out, go watch the vlog of that because it was fun to see the boys all back together being boys.
Right. Oh my goodness. Because
like they're playing with the dog.
They're still 8 years old.
Yeah.
Right? Like, just the same.
You want to move on to Keto on the Couch?
Yes, please.
So it's kind of weird because Keto on the Couch actually originally started as we're going to tell you about our week, share a few comments. It evolved into all about you guys. And now that we're daily vlogging, there's really no reason to talk about
us at all.
Our food stuff.
So yeah.
We want to jump right into you guys because like I said, Keto on the Couch is all about you. We love sharing subscriber stories, wins, answering questions, and things like that. So we're going to jump right into our first segment, which is the Keto College Adjunct Professor of the Week. These are a couple of comments that we found very inspirational. First one that we have is actually from Francine.
Hi, Francine.
Francine just put up this nice little, like, it's a picture of a truck. It said, the best weight you're ever going to lose is the weight of others' opinions of you.
Boy, howdy. Is that accurate?
Yeah.
Right? Like, we really were blessed this week to be with our family at Thanksgiving, and you and I are the only keto people. So that entire picture, everybody was, you know, is awesome, but not everybody is keto. And I gotta tell you, I felt fully supported and encouraged. Even Michelle's parents were like, tell me more about like what it is that you brought. I would love to try that. You know, we had brought even some Chalk Zero candy, like chocolate, with us to put out. And they tried it and were really nice about it. It wasn't like they were like, ew.
Right.
You know, they had some of the drop biscuits. And they were so encouraging to us. Like, I felt very supportive. But not everybody had that experience this Thanksgiving. For some people, it was surviving Thanksgiving because you feel undermined or you feel like you're made fun of and all of that. And I really hope and pray that you just shook that off because you don't need to carry that. You know, like if someone is being mean to you or undermining, don't take that into your week. Leave it behind. That day is over. Just like if you had an off-plan day during the Thanksgiving celebration and you're feeling like, man, I should have done things differently, leave that day behind and move forward with your week.
Yeah. Next one that we have is from Leah.
Hey, Leah.
Leah said, happy Thanksgiving. I hope everybody's enjoying their holiday. If you ate off plan, it's okay.
Yeah.
Don't be hard on ourselves. Remember, tomorrow is another day. Get right back on your plan. I believe in you all.
Thanks so much for that reminder, because that's exactly how I feel. Same thing.
Yep.
Just move on. That day is over. Thankfully, sometimes you're thankful for the day and sometimes you're thankful the day is over.
Yeah. Now, even though we didn't go off of keto, we definitely went off of what our plan has been for the last few weeks. We ate a lot of cranberry sauce.
I was going to say,
it was delicious.
I didn't prioritize protein. I prioritized cranberry sauce and drop biscuits.
And the other thing that we did not do that we didn't even think about because we were so into the day, you know, I got up in the morning making the pork belly, and you got to get out the door and you got an hour and a half drive to get there and then you're around everybody. Neither one of us did any electrolytes. And
we
guess
drank
what?
Water.
The next day, we paid for that because it's just a habit for us, but the whole day was different than our normal thing. So even though that's not like eating off plan, that was off of our normal plan. But you know what? We just, Friday morning, we got up and said, boy, I don't feel as good as normal. And we thought about it and we were like, we didn't do any electrolytes at all. We didn't even drink as much fluid as we normally do. Got right back into it. And by noon, we were completely fine.
We were back to normal. And again, when I stepped on the scale, you're not supposed to. Like,
right.
Don't do that.
Don't
be dumb like me. But I got on. One thing, thankfully, after we've come through this challenge, I don't believe the scale
I
used to.
The scale
is the devil. So
and the mirror is a liar.
So I almost wanted to look on it, you know, get on it to be like, what do you got to say today? Knowing that once I got my electrolytes and kept, you know, went back to eating. Sorry about that. I'll be fine.
Right.
So it was like 4 or 5 pounds up. Like he's saying, by noon, it was all gone and back to normal. So again, you can't step on the scale after a holiday and then judge yourself by that because you're just going to be upset. And if you'll just give it some time, it'll be gone.
Let's take a quick commercial break and come back with our subscribers of the week.
Are you on the nice list or the naughty list this year?
Depends on who you ask.
I know. I feel like I'm straddling the line. You know, I'm on the fence still. It could be either way.
Reading some of the comments, we're on the nice list. There's other comments,
we're on a naughty list. Right. You know, I'm going to write into Santa and see if there's any extra credit work that I can do. That's what we used to do to the teachers, right? Like, this is the time where you're asking for extra credit.
Let's get into the subscriber of the week. Now, if you're new to our channel, this is a segment where we like to share stories from our subscribers because that's what Keto on the Couch is all about. And we really say this all the time. It is so important that you share your story. Share your story with us. Share your story with other people. Share your story when you're out on the road. When people say, hey, how did you lose weight? I eat the proper human diet. Oh, what's that? And then you can explain, hey, I don't eat sugar anymore. I don't eat pasta and grains and that kind of stuff. You don't even have to use the word keto. But we ask you to share your story because there are people out there who they're all alone And when you share your story, you're going to inspire them. It's not that we need content, but we want a community where people can come together and feel supported. That's why we started our Two Crazy Ketos family group. That's always been our dream, to have this nice tight-knit community of people who can just support each other. So if you want to share your story, please do it. And you can do it two ways. You can send us an email at stories@twocrazyketos.com, or you can head on over to our Facebook group and you can leave it there. You can even put a story down in the comment section, but unfortunately down there you can't share any pictures. So the first one that we have is from Glenn.
Hey, Glenn.
Glenn said, I started eating differently on December 23rd, 2019, when I read a book from Dr. Ken Berry, Lies My Doctor Told Me. I will leave a link for that book down below. I have lowered my A1C from 6.1 to 5.1.
Wow, Glenn.
Normalized my blood pressure, relieved 96% of all my joint pain and my inflammation. Wow. I was diagnosed with congestive heart failure in 2018. I had a heart scan on November 2nd, 2021, and it was normal.
Yay!
I've been on keto carnivore for almost 2 years now, and I feel better than I have in 30 years. I was 410 pounds when I started and I could hardly walk. I had bad hip joint bone on bone with no balance.
Oh, wow.
I now walk 2 to 6 miles several days a week with a wheeled walker.
Wow.
I now weigh 280 pounds
Glenn!
And I'm turning 60 in December. Looking forward to getting down to 200 to 220. I am 6'3" and I'm supposed to weigh 180 pounds. Thanks to Two Crazy Ketos family for the love and the support. God bless everyone.
Glenn! Wow! You look fantastic, sir. Also, there ain't no way anybody's gonna believe that you're gonna hit 60.
You look 10 years younger in that picture, and that's
really
what, two years later.
You really do. Wow, you look absolutely fantastic. And I am so excited for you. I love hearing this, especially when it hits home for me when you talk about reversing situations when it comes to heart trouble, because that's how I lost my dad. So I am so excited to see this reversal in your health, Glenn.
And just looking back at that picture for a minute, look at how much cleaner his skin looks.
Oh, it's fantastic.
Right? Like looking at his face, like the skin, everything looks cleaner and smoother. You look amazing. Congratulations, Glenn.
Way to go.
Next one we have is from Jean.
Hey, Jean.
Jean said, 18 months ago, the me on the top had the courage to just try again. After a lifetime of failures at getting my health under control and feeling sicker than ever, I tried one more time. How I look now is the least of it, but the most visible. Also, I'm convinced that the crux of my issues wasn't the added weight, but all of the junk that I was poisoning my body with.
That's good.
Things that healed when I stopped eating that stuff. Dandruff, chronic sinus infections, rosacea, brain fog, frequent strep throat, gums healed. They had started to recede a little. Teeth grinding, sleep apnea, no more CPAP machine, acid reflux, gas and bloating, inflammation in my joints, fibromyalgia pain, bladder issues, high blood pressure, seasonal allergies, and even improvements in my mood. I feel good. Don't remember the last time I felt this good. Additionally, when you slay a huge dragon in your life, you feel empowered to meet more goals.
Yep.
The momentum feels amazing. 100 pounds gone.
Oh, Gene, way to go. Look at that tiny little waist, girl. Wow, you look fantastic, and somebody needed to hear that entire list of stuff. If that won't keep you on track during the holidays, I don't know what will, because it's like a list to Santa, right? If you could say before keto, what would you like for Christmas? It would be listing all of these things I don't want to have to be dealing with anymore, right? It was like the bloating and the sleep apnea and like the grinding of the teeth and like, yes, gums receding. You are absolutely right. All of those things. So thank you for sharing it, because what an amazing success you've had, not just the weight loss, but all of those health issues. And it began with saying, I'm gonna give it one more try. I love that attitude.
Yeah. You know, a lot of us come to keto for weight loss and then we discover the health issues.
Yeah.
But one thing I will say is, like, keto, it's not about weight loss. It's about health improvement. And the weight loss is a side effect.
Yeah.
And that's more of the attitude that I'm adopting. You know, every once in a while we get comments, you guys don't look like you've lost much weight, or you look like you have a bunch of weight to lose still.
Thanks for that.
So thank you for that, by the way, because you just keep me motivated. But, you know, those kind of comments, my answer is, it's about health issues too.
Yeah.
And do I have a few more pounds to lose? Yeah, probably. I feel amazing. But you know what? I'm not on arthritis medication anymore. And I can move. And as somebody recently pointed out, I actually think it's in the comments in this video, you know, I'm able to crawl underneath a cabinet or crawl under my RV or stand up paddleboard.
I can get down on the ground and know that I can get back up again if I'm playing with kids at work. Like, all of these things are huge successes, and it makes us enjoy our everyday life. Right. It's more than what size you're wearing. It is so much more than that. Yeah. Think about your life. What is life? You get dressed and you get undressed and you get dressed again. That's a very small part of your day compared to living it.
Yeah, I think about the fact that when we started keto, or before we started keto, both of us had blood pressure at stroke level.
Yeah.
And now our blood pressure is normal.
Right.
Both of us, we know for a fact that Rachel was pre-diabetic. No longer. It's not even an issue for us. When you look at our numbers, you know, yes, people are going to say your total cholesterol is high, but all the other numbers are amazing. Also, I did want to mention, I will leave a link for this video right up here, but Dr. Boz actually just put up a great video using graphics. She's amazing at this kind of stuff. Talking about how LDL, it's actually, an LDL is actually good, and I'm not gonna try to explain it, but go watch that video because it really is amazing, because she's talking about a patient who has high LDL but low triglycerides. So go watch that video.
It's fascinating.
Okay, let's get into the comments from last week's Keto on the Couch. The first one is gonna be from Kristen.
Hey Kristen, she says, Joe, I think doing the garbage disposal is a testament to keto. At 300 pounds, how well would you have been able to get down on the floor and work in a kitchen cabinet? It takes a lot of folding of the middle body to do all that. And when you are overweight, nothing folds.
It's absolutely true. And I didn't even think about that because I was raised to do all your own work. That's just how we were raised, that we try not to hire out subcontractors because we want to rather take that money and put it into family trips and that kind of stuff.
Ribeye budget.
And ribeye budget. So that's how I was raised. But now I read that comment during the week and I'm like, yeah, because yes, I did this stuff before, but I think about the pain that I was in when we were doing it. I think about when we bought this house and I put a wood floor throughout the entire house, and the next morning I would get up and I couldn't move anymore because I was almost 300 pounds when I was doing that. And now I just don't have those issues. And that's several years later.
Well, and it's same for me. I can remember when I cleaned my house this morning, cleaned everything. Used to be, that was it for the day. Yeah. I would clean my house and because it had to be done, and I would farm strong it, right? Mm-hmm. Like you do. And I mean, you have to get on your knees and like do the toilet and all the glamorous jobs of a mom.
You've done a great job, by the way.
Thank you so much. And it smells like Christmas around here, P.S. But that was it. Mm-hmm. It was like, go to bed after that. There was nothing else to do. And we have an entire day left.
Well, your reward is, there is a prime rib roast in the sous vide right now.
That was worth cleaning the turbot.
And as soon as we're done, we get to go eat that thing.
Yay.
Next one is from Chassinette.
What a beautiful name.
Said, with respect to stalls, I love what Dr. Barry says. It is not a stall until 6 months. 6 months. Way to add some perspective and some grace to our bodies as they acclimate to the changes. I think of it as maintaining.
That is a great perspective.
You know what? I've heard him say that before and it kind of just goes right past me. But yeah, reading that again, you know, so many people are like, well, I've been in a stall for 2 weeks. I've been in a stall for 3 weeks. As Dr. Barry says, 6 months. And sometimes you may be in a stall on the scale, but there's other things going on.
Right.
Even if you don't see a body change, there's things happening inside. Your body's healing. You're reversing your insulin resistance, possibly. You're getting rid of your fatty liver. There's no way that we can see that, but it is happening when we're on the proper human diet. Now, remember, we are not doctors or nurses. This is just our experience from what other people have talked about. But yeah, sometimes there's inward change that we don't see on the outside.
Well, and you think about that, if that's when you check in and you're like, okay, let me survey, and we're approaching, you know, a famous 6 month mark, right? January. So if you take January to June and you're doing things and you're incorporating things and you're saying like, okay, in June, July, let's take a look at like, do I like where I'm at, or do I need to increase my movement? Do I need to switch out a few things? Like, that is a better marker to see like where you at than every single day, like 14, 15 times a day, like stressing out, get on the scale. What do I need to do? I need to change right. this. I mean, you're gonna make yourself crazy.
Yeah. Next one is from Sarah.
Hey, Sarah. She says, the best sermon I ever heard was about you have to love yourself if you're going to love others well. I was very angry because loving people is what I live for, but I did not love me. Now that I know how to love me, I know exactly what that sermon was about. I love so much better now that I love myself.
Wow. That is an amazing statement. And that's another statement that I've heard before, but it's kind of like the in one ear, out the other, until you're living it. And there was definitely a time where I did not love myself. So yeah, how do you love somebody either through expressing it or just, you know, like emotionally? If you can't love yourself, you don't know what it's like and how to properly love somebody else.
Well, my thing was, and you're so right, Sarah, because I would think to myself, I don't like how I feel. Like my emotions would be up and down, you know, before keto when I wasn't taking care of myself at all. And I would be like, I'm angry that I'm so angry. Mm-hmm. I'm upset that I feel mad. But that was the thing. I was loving everybody else. And I thought, well, that's good enough. I just am going to have me as the exception. I will love everyone else. And then I will reserve the right to hate myself. And I hated myself for a good long time. But it doesn't work. It just doesn't work. You are not going to feel joy in your life, even if you are so solid good at loving everybody else, if you hate yourself. You just can't do it. You have to start loving yourself. And if that means that you have to start writing yourself love notes, if you have to write yourself messages on your mirror, like, get started. And it's gonna feel very weird and foreign to start doing nice things and start treating yourself nicely, because it felt weird to me to start liking that woman in the mirror and giving her a break.
Next one is from Karen.
Hey, Karen.
Karen said, I discovered 2KK about 6 weeks ago. I don't have tons of weight to lose, maybe 15 pounds. I've lost about 4 to 5 with 15 to go. The going is slow on the scale, but I think I'm seeing body composition changes. Thank you so much for posting your before pictures of yourselves with Rachel's mother. Wow, wow, wow. I have heard you mention that you had been quite overweight, but the visual compared to the present visual is amazing. The important thing to note is that the transformation didn't happen overnight.
Yeah.
It happened over the course of several years. One of my favorite phrases is progress, not perfection. Mm-hmm. Thanks for being such supportive inspirations to so many.
Thanks so much for that. I really appreciate that. And, you know, sometimes we forget where we came from. It takes a Facebook memories photo to remember like how far we've come.
Yeah, sometimes the photos that we put up, they're also to remind us of where we came from. Next one is from Dawn.
Hey, Dawn. She says, I love the statement as to know your why. Your why may change as time goes on and your weight loss progresses. My why when I started was to lose weight. I dropped 100 pounds. My why now is to be healthy. I have so much energy now. I lift weights and have muscle tone. 4 years ago, I was in the Dominican Republic and climbed a mountain to go down some waterfalls. I could barely make it. I can't wait to go back and accomplish this now. Embrace your why, because it will push and motivate you.
It is so true. We talked about that last week. You need to find your why. And then when you find your why, put little signs and notes all over your house reminding you of what your why is.
Well, and I like the fact that she said that your why can change over time.
Yeah.
Because it absolutely does. I think about, you know, when we started keto, we weren't thinking about sharing a family dinner at one of our children's houses.
Right.
Because they were living, he was living with us when we started keto.
Right.
But now watching them play in the backyard and be together, you know, we were thinking about the future, like grandkids and like the kids getting older and us just sitting there thinking, man, we're gonna be there for a long time.
That's
right. So our why has definitely changed too.
Next one is from Synergy.
Hey, Synergy.
Synergy said, treating ourselves well is so important. It didn't come naturally, but years ago, I taught myself to love myself and to be kind to myself no matter what. It helps when times are good and when times are tough. I like to celebrate little things every day, like a towel that wraps all the way around you, the lightness to my step, the clear thinking all day long, and so much more. With so many wonderful things to celebrate, who cares about a number on a scale?
Wow, and again, I never see these comments that he pulls before he pulls them, and I don't think that you try to curate anything.
I honestly don't. I just go down and be like, that's an inspirational post, so
somebody
I'm gonna take that one out.
Somebody needs to hear this today. It's time to start loving you.
That's right.
I love you. Joe loves you. You are loved by people that you don't even realize in your realm of influence. They do care about you. And somebody right now, you need to hear this. You need to start loving you. It's time. It's time now.
Next one is from Sharonda.
Hey, Sharonda. She says, hi, my name is Sharonda. Last week, I said I was going to try and start back on keto. I want to report that I succeeded at my first week and lost 10 pounds. Most of my blotting is gone. Acid reflux, so much better. Can't wait for more results. Keep praying for me. Sharonda, we absolutely will.
Absolutely. So Sharonda was actually featured last week, so I wanted to put that follow-up post. And again, everybody is different. You know, if you've been eating a tremendous amount of carbs, and your body is just kind of all filled with those glycogen stores and everything. Sometimes on the first week, you're gonna drop a whole bunch of weight. A lot of the times it's just your glycogen stores in water, but I want you to encourage you, keep going. And if you are somebody else and you don't drop 10 pounds in the week, that doesn't mean you're not successful. Everybody's body is different. My first month, I lost 25 pounds. Rachel's first month, she lost a pound. So just remember that. Don't judge yourself by other people's success.
No, and I love that you checked in and just said like, hey, I just wanted to let you know I'm still on it and I had a successful week. I mean, when we were part of Weight Watchers, we had to pay for that.
Right.
We had to pay money to tell somebody I stuck to it this week. So you use the Facebook family group, use the comment section of YouTube videos, email us and let us know, hey, I'm sticking with it, because sometimes accountability is a great thing. And you've got a family that we're cheering for you. We want to know what's happening.
You know, you mentioned the Weight Watchers thing, and here's the funny part about Weight Watchers. That is the one thing that I never did. I never did Weight Watchers, except for the beginning of the year when we were playing around with the app and you know, that kind of stuff. But I did do Jenny Craig, and I did do Nutrisystem back when they had centers that you went into.
Mm-hmm.
And you had to go in and weigh in, right? And then be told by them, hey, you're having a good week, or hey, what did you do wrong? You're screwing up. I paid for the privilege of them to reprimand me,
right?
I paid for that privilege, for them to reprimand me. And then because I didn't want to be reprimanded, I did stupid things, like took water pills a few hours before going in to get weighed. Now, who was I fooling?
Nobody.
I'm fooling them, right? But am I actually losing weight? No, it's like, hey, tomorrow's weigh-in day, so I'm not gonna eat today. Why? So that we can see that number on the scale?
Yeah.
And so like, that's why I love this family, because this family doesn't care. This family is there to continue to support you and to continue uplifting you.
Well, and I would rather have someone just check in and say, like, you don't need to tell me your weight or your size or anything. Just say like, hey, I stuck to keto this week. Mm-hmm. I'm still doing it. I'm going strong.
Next one is from Adrian.
Hey, Adrian, I know you have discussed it before, but can't find the post. Can I get your advice on getting a pellet grill or a Camaro Joe or another gas grill? My gas grill is on its last legs. I don't have a vented stove, and cooking at high temperatures inside often results in smoke alarm going off. I want easy for a 61-year-old female to use by myself.
Okay. We're actually considering doing like a video on grills. So let us know down in the comment section if that is something that you would be interested in. I do have a lot of experience with a lot of different grills, including several pellet smokers. So we were thinking about putting that video together. So I'm curious if that's something that you guys would want. But with respect to this post, here's my suggestion. If you want something easy, my answer is always gonna be get a pellet grill. It doesn't necessarily matter which brand because they're all similar. They're all running on the same technology from the Traeger from years ago. It's just right. The patents changed up and so now you have all these different companies. I have a preference for the Rectech for a few reasons. Number one, it is stainless steel. Number two, they have a phenomenal warranty. Number three, they have really good customer service. But you can also get a Pit Boss, which you can get at your local Walmart or Lowe's. They're much cheaper. They do come with a good warranty. You could get a Traeger. The reason I always say get a pellet grill is because it's so easy. Even Rachel can use it.
It really is easy to use.
It's to steal from the old Ron Popeil commercials, it's literally set it and forget it. Take your meat, prepare it with like a salt rub, or if you're gonna brine it, or if you're gonna put seasoning on it, you put a temperature probe in there, you stick it in there, you set it for whatever temperature, usually like 225, 250 degrees, and you wait for it to be done.
Right.
It's very difficult to screw it up unless you just ignore the fact that the temperature has gotten to your desired cooking temperature. But other than that, it's easy. It's the Kamado Joe, I love that thing. It is fun. I am not a super experienced pit master like, you know, you're gonna see, you know, in Texas and in other places. I'm learning how to do that, but there is a lot more that you have to mess with. You have to mess with top notches and you have to mess with airflow on the bottom and learning how to adjust temperature without a computer.
Right.
So if you are a 61 or anybody who's looking
or just
for
Rachel.
A super simple grill, I would go with a pellet grill. And if even for a barbecue, I would go with a pellet grill because the pellet grill is going to allow you to smoke food and grill food. Whereas if you got a regular barbecue, you could smoke, but you're back into that. You have to learn how to maintain the temperature.
I was going to say, because even when we've had like regular charcoal briquettes, you know, things, it was up to you to maintain it. I love that the wood pellets are doing
it. Does it all for you.
It just dumps it in when it needs to be higher.
Let's take a quick commercial break and come back with the Facebook comments.
What's at the top of your list for Santa?
A professional knife set.
Oh my Lord. I don't know if he makes those in the North Pole. I want a paper planner.
I can give you a planner right now. Where's your phone? Here, give me your phone.
That is not a paper planner.
It's a planner.
That
though.
Is an electronic planner.
Let us know down in the comment section. Are you a paper planner or are you an electronic planner? I like electronic planner. I even just recently invested in a new app for my phone and my computer called Fantastical.
That is fantastical.
It allows you to integrate all of your different calendars and awesome. It even alerts you when my calendar updates. You can't do that with a paper planner.
I am so excited for you right now. So excited.
Let's get into the Facebook comments. The first one is from Jean.
Hey Jean, as we can all tell stories, I too have one of struggles and doubts about weight loss and improved health. But with this community, I have found new strength when I fall back or stall on my goal progress. And for that, I will always be grateful. Thank you all for your stories and encouragement to each of us. Even when you're not talking to me or about me, the messages speak to me. I've been stalled for what felt like forever after losing 25 pounds fairly fast. I understand that much of it was water weight, so I stayed the course, but I found myself fluctuating up and down 1 to 2 pounds. Today, I finally dropped to a new low and it had me jumping. Well, perhaps just hopping so I don't injure this old man. I'm down 27.4 pounds and just another 36 pounds to go to get to a healthy weight. I have high blood pressure and type 2 diabetes, so weight loss is more about my health than getting back to my beach body. But my wife of 48 years likes the body transformation too.
First of all, congratulations, Gene. I mean, I'm just trying to picture Gene jumping up and down right
now
because we got to hang out with him in Las Vegas.
He's so fun.
But it just ties into everything we were talking about earlier. Like, from not worrying about the scale and not getting frustrated because sometimes it's just water weight, sometimes there's healing going on
sticking
in our body.
Sticking with it.
But the other thing is as he said, when you guys share your stories, one way or another, it is always speaking to him. So please share your stories. If nobody shared their story, Gene might not be where he's at right now.
That's right.
Right? So it's so important to share those stories. Next one is from Frankie.
Hey, Frankie.
Frankie said, I'm having so much trouble sticking to keto now that I'm going out with friends and family for dinner more. Is anyone else having trouble with this, or does anyone have great resource to stay on track? Okay. So this may sound cold, but I have Rachel next to me who's going to be able to step up and make my comment nice.
Uh-oh.
Sometimes you have to be the priority. When you're going out to eat, you have to be the priority. There are not many restaurants out there. In fact, the only style food that I can think of off the top of my head that may be very difficult to turn keto is Italian, like going out to an Italian restaurant.
Yeah.
But other than that, you can pretty much somehow at least keto-fy every cuisine out there.
Cuisine.
You can go to Texas Roadhouse and say, I want a steak with no vegetables, or don't put any seasoning on it. I don't want any bread. You can go to a burger joint and say, I want the burger without the bread. So sometimes you just need to prioritize yourself over your friends and family that you're going out with, because that goes back to the love thing, right? We have to love ourselves first. But also you have to prioritize, like, how important is it for you to have success on the proper human diet?
Well, first of all, I don't think that's mean what you're saying. I may not have something like super sweet to say. My thought is, how bad do you want this?
Yeah.
How bad do you want this? And how long are you willing to wait to get serious? Because I think that's a lot of times what we do is we push pause for the holidays. And my thing is, if I'm pushing pause on feeling good, why am I pushing pause on feeling good? Mm-hmm. Like, I want to start feeling good right now. I really want to enjoy the holiday season. I really want to enjoy my friends. I really want to enjoy outings, and I don't want to wait. I want to start enjoying it right now. So I do also go out with friends to dinner. I usually go straight to Yelp first, and I check out the menus of wherever it is that they want to go. If they don't, like, ask me, hey, you know, what are my, you know, restaurant requirements, because right. I will tell them if they ask me. But if they choose the restaurant, I will go in first. I will even make a phone call mm-hmm. to the restaurant if I think, hey, can I order it this way? And just kind of do some legwork before we get to the restaurant so that I feel confident sitting down at the table or booth and knowing, like, hey, I have a plan for today.
Yeah. If you are serious enough, and again, this may sound harsh, but if you are serious enough about eating the proper human diet and losing weight, and more importantly, affecting and changing your health for the better, you'll be okay with maybe embarrassing yourself a little bit.
Yeah.
You'll be okay with, you know what? I paid $10 for this burger and I'm throwing out the bun and I'm probably paying $3. You're gonna be okay with it. You're prioritizing your health. You're gonna be okay with telling a waiter, hey, I'm allergic to sugar. Please make sure I'm not getting anything that has sugar in it. You're gonna be okay. In fact, we did this and Rachel looked at me and this was my answer. We were getting ready to go to Thanksgiving and Rachel saw me taking the stuffing that we made for that one stuffing video. I'll leave a link for it right up here. And I was putting some in a Tupperware container to bring with me. And she's like, what are you doing? They made stuffing. I'm like, they didn't make keto stuffing. And I really want stuffing with my turkey. And she's like, are we going to offend them? You're going, right. And I'm like, you know what? You're going to have to love me for who I am, right? This is a holiday. I'm not asking you to make anything special for me, but I'm going to bring something so that I can be a part of the entire celebration.
Yeah. And you know what? It turned out that no one was offended.
Right.
Everybody was fine with
it. Sometimes it's in our head.
Yeah, sometimes, right. Well, and I think to myself, like, that was really insulting of me to come into my family space and thinking my family would be upset with me.
Right.
Because we brought something we could eat.
Right.
Why do I have such a low opinion of how my family's gonna react? I should have good expectations that my family will be awesome.
Yeah.
And they were. So why am I surprised at that, right? Yep.
Next one is from Tammy.
Hey, Tammy, non-skill victory. Went to pull up my leggings after getting out of the shower tonight and they went clean up over my boobies. Good thing I thought ahead and brought a size smaller as well. Oh my gosh, Tammy, I flippin' Love that.
I read that one. I read it out loud to Rachel. I'm like, this is going in there.
Yes.
It's going in there.
I did know about
it. And here's the other thing is that, you know, and she's talking about her leggings, and I don't have experience wearing leggings, but I do have experience putting on occasionally a compression shirt because, you know, especially when I go do sports officiating and stuff, and you wear compression all the time.
I do.
And when you get out of the shower and your skin still has all that moisture, sometimes it doesn't slip on very easily,
no,
right?
No, it doesn't. That's a huge non-scale victory. And I have experienced that, especially with like the high waistband yoga pants, that it's like, it came on, like, it's keep going. Oh my gosh, I'm about to make my own turtleneck. Like, it just keeps going up.
Next one is from Cindy.
Hey, Cindy.
Cindy said, I wish they'd come up with a gadget like a meat thermometer that you could stick a probe into any food or drink and it would tell you exactly how many carbs are in it.
Cindy,
yes. Get moving.
Oh my gosh, please invent that because I will totally purchase that and one for all of my family members.
Next one is from James.
Hey, James. He says, this afternoon, I've come to the startling conclusion if I drink a Bang, it will have me wired and this seems to help me survive the stress and chaos of work. I'm trapped and in serious trouble. I can't afford to get addicted to these things. There needs to be a natural way I can have an energy boost, sustain it, and get me over the hump. Can't continue to live life this way.
Okay. I thought it was... That's one of the reasons we don't drink Bangs anymore. Once in a blue moon.
Crazy.
And then you want one every day because it is so sweet. It started triggering a sweet tooth. So we'll... On a trip, sometimes we'll have one. I'm going to make a suggestion to you, and that would be... Try not to drink the Bangs,
yeah.
You know, because I know you're looking for that energy boost. And one of the things I'm going to recommend is the new Redmond Boost.
Yes.
And you can get it both in capsules if you don't want to have any kind of sweetener, if you just want a little capsule, or you can get it in the new powder.
It tastes good.
The powder tastes really good. You're going to get some electrolytes and you're going to get some natural energy there. You know, also... I would probably do some exogenous ketones before doing the Bang. You know, we don't really promote exogenous ketones a lot because a lot of people think exogenous ketones put you into a deeper state of ketosis for losing weight, and they don't. They do serve a purpose. Their purpose is to help you raise your ketones to give you a little bit more cognitive function, give you a little bit more boost energy, but it's very short-lived. It's also really good for people who are doing this for medicinal purposes, like, you know, they have maybe, you know, epilepsy or something right. like that where they require high ketones. But if you did some exogenous ketones, that might help. You don't need as many. It won't cost you as much money. And it will give you that energy and that clarity to get through the rest of your day.
There was like this meme that was talking about how like, you know, I drank a Bang energy to like go to work. And then it was like, it shows the person like they wandered out into the wilderness somehow and like were punching a tree. And I felt like that's how I get on it. Yeah. And I mean, they're delicious going down. But I feel crazy. I just can't do it.
Next one is from Michelle.
Hey, Michelle.
Michelle said, I decided last minute to make chocolate toffee cheesecake recipe.
Yay.
I wonder if it would be good with any flavor. I have tried it yet, though, and it's got to cool in the fridge for a few hours.
I think it tastes good with any flavor.
You can absolutely, I will leave a link for that up here, but that recipe is probably the one of the ones that I'm most proud of. I think the only thing that really beats it out would be my pie crust.
Yeah, your pie crust.
Which you need for that recipe.
Yeah.
But, and then the keto chow chili, that one too. But no, that really is delicious with any flavor keto chow.
Not taco.
Any flavor keto chow that is sweet. And I think anything that's got that more like rounded flavor, like I don't know if I want a strawberry cream pie, although some people might.
Raspberry.
But the raspberry, it's really good with raspberry. It's really good with the chocolate toffee. It's really good with the chocolate peanut butter. Salted caramel makes a really good pie. And think about cheesecake.
Yeah.
You know, you go to like, what is that? Cheesecake Factory. Think about all the different flavors
caramel
they have
macchiato
there.
Caramel macchiato works really well with it too. Because yeah. It's like, if you've ever liked, you know, like a coffee cheesecake, it's really
the
good.
The key lime, all those flavors will make a really, really good cheesecake. Next one's from Jenny.
Hey, Jenny. Started BBB&E Sunday. Said I'd do keto for today, Christmas Eve and Christmas Day. Keto started dinner last night with my college girl home. I put the scale away Sunday, went off coffee, had one cup today, and asked my husband and daughter if I look like I've lost already. Both said for sure, yes. I want to pull out the scale before January 1st, but I made a commitment, and I'll keep going. Already feeling my clothes looser. Jenny, that is so awesome, and I'm so proud of you. And I hope everybody who's making any kind of change hears that statement. I think that that's the most powerful sentence there. I made a commitment. Mm-hmm. I honor my commitments. That's why challenges work so well for me, because I am a woman of my word. So if I promised myself something, even if I'm struggling to do the right thing, I made a commitment. If I commit to volunteer at something or do something, you can guarantee I'm gonna show up because I committed. I said I would do it.
Yeah.
So I will do it. So that's something to bring into your health goals. You are a person of commitment.
Next one is from Jamie.
Hey, Jamie.
Jamie said, confession. I pretend to be mad when a boiled eggs won't peel right. But really, I just want the yolk anyway.
Aw.
That is so true. Rachel will tell you, like, I will try to, like, peel eggs. Sometimes, like, I'll do one with a really fresh egg or something, and then it won't peel. And I get super frustrated, and I'm, like, throwing it around. I'm like, oh, I really just wanted the yolk.
Well, that's what you were doing that like last week, and you were saying, well, I'm just going to eat the best part anyway.
Next one is from Shelly.
Hey, Shelly, talk about timing and synchronicity. I was just watching Coach Bronson's new video about finding your why during the holidays. A family member who knows how I eat and why came in the room and offered me cookies. Not mad about it, just said no. Sabotage is always about the person doing it and their insecurities. Remember your why.
That is so true. And it's something that aggravates me sometimes. You know, I've had people come out like, I can't believe you eat that way. And my response, I've gotten bold, but we've been doing this for 4 years, but I've gotten bold. I'm like, how come you didn't say something to me before? Like, why didn't you say anything to me when I would sit there and eat a package of cookies, right? But now they make comments. And then you have to remember, sometimes people are just upset with themselves and right. They don't want to see success. That's why you see, you know, you watch those shows like 600 Pound Life and you see like family members sabotaging them, because if they have success, that kind of takes away any reason why you can't have success.
Right. Hurt people hurt people. And when I think that, you know, when someone does something that seems kind of undermining or hurtful, I think to myself, hurt people. And suddenly I have grace for that person, because I expect a hurt person to hurt somebody. I expect if a dog is injured or wounded, like if you see one of those shows where it's like an animal keeper that's like collecting an animal that's like, you know, a wild, you know, a feral cat or something, and they're hurt or injured and you're just trying to get them to the vet. That's all you're doing. You are very well-meaning, and that dog or cat snaps. It's not because it's necessarily a bad animal. Mm-hmm. It's just hurting.
That's right.
So if you can see it as like, poor thing, you don't mean this. It's just that you're hurting and I'm getting bit for it.
Yeah. Next one is from Jerry.
Hey, Jerry, what is the best brand of seasoning to use on a keto plan?
I'm going to tell you Redmond. There's very few seasonings out there. The flat iron seasonings are pretty good too. Heath actually has one that he's put together. The problem with most of the store-bought seasonings is they put a lot of fillers in there. They put maltodextrin in there. They put things in there so that they don't cake. I'm not so much worried about those, but when you start adding maltodextrin and dextrose and all those sugars, like the chili seasonings, like I've never found a chili seasoning that doesn't have that stuff in there. That's why we put together our own. I'll leave a link for that recipe down below. But that the best thing, if you just want overall seasonings, get the Redmond. Redmond has three really good clean seasonings. So they have the organic garlic pepper, which we're using on all our roasts and
all
our ribs and everything like that. They have a lemon pepper one, which works on everything, but it's really good on chicken wings and chicken breast. And then they have the just organic seasoned salt, which is very similar to like Alari's. As a matter of fact, when we were at Michelle's house, we brought a little one. We had a small little, I don't know what those are, 10 ounce container or whatever.
It's small. It's what a normal size seasoning would be, right. But it's small to us now.
We brought her one as a little gift and figured that we could be able to put it on our food anyway. And her mom picked it up, and then they also had some Lowry's, and she's like, this is very similar.
Yeah.
I'm like, yeah, and it doesn't have the sugar and all the chemicals. And she started reading down the list of ingredients on the other seasonings that they had, and she was like, wow. And I'm like, yeah, they don't even put any kind of anti-caking agent or anything in there. Little side note, I did find, if you're like us in Florida and you do get some of that caking in those ones, get some of the Decadent packets. Mm-hmm. I'll leave a link for them down below. They have food grade ones. Just drop a couple in there. It absorbs all the humidity and the moisture.
No more problems.
And no more problems with it caking up and clumping in the bottom. Next one is from Leanne.
Hey, Leanne. If labels were honest, you'd see that you've got diabetes in a box, Choco Crap, and Beyond Meat Chemical Boop Storm plant-based burger patties.
I just thought it was funny.
Accurate.
I mean, Dr. Barry talks about that all the time,
truth
right?
Truth in advertising.
But unfortunately, we don't. And I will never forget when we got into keto and about 6 months in, and I started thinking about when the boys were younger, and again, when you know better, you do better. They would want a donut, and we would say, no, let's have a bowl of cereal.
Right.
I should have just let them have the donut, right?
There's so much. I mean, I can't forget, like, recently I was in Starbucks, and I was just, like, waiting in line, and they had, like, a salad, and I thought, this would be probably something a parent would grab and go, like, a kid has a field trip, and you forgot to pack it. Like, maybe you don't normally pack your kid's lunch, and right. So I could see them grabbing it because it was a salad and had the utensils and everything in it. And it had such an astronomical amount of carbohydrates and sugar in it. And I thought, it's a salad. I know I think I'm reaching for something that's going to be healthy.
Right.
But it's not.
We have one more. It is from Alexandria.
Hey, Alexandria.
And she said, after being keto for almost a year, I had a rocky 9 months, moving, financial troubles, relocated job. But I finally got back on the proper human diet train on November 1st. I did my initial measurements and blood work and won't be checking the scale for some time.
Good job.
Motivated to do a 90-day BBBE challenge starting New Year's Day after seeing what you guys experienced. Just living these 3 weeks keto-vore, again, my joints and my inflammation have improved drastically.
So awesome.
It's amazing how you mentally block the daily pain because stuffing your face with sugar and carbs brainwashes you.
Yeah.
From watching 2KK and Serious Keto again every day has been a great support system for me getting back on track since nobody around me wants to cut the carbs. Feeling great and looking forward to 2022 and the proper human diet. Thanks for everything you do.
Wow. Thank you so much for sharing that. And, you know, I know that it is challenging and we've experienced it too. Like when, you know, you'd be officiating and you're the only guy that you know that's on keto. And I would go to work and I'm the only person that is on keto. I know that it is hard being the only person doing something. But in the back part of my mind, I think to myself, I'm probably the only person that is not feeling any inflammation. I'm not feeling any pain. I am probably the only person that has this extreme clarity. I am the only person that got up with the energy that I need to power my day. I don't need to bring in outside sugar to help me boost up. Like, I feel fantastic. And P.S., I'm the oldest person at work, or you're the oldest person that you're officiating with. Like, that is kind of awesome to be the only one. That's in right. A good way.
Yep. Hold on 1 second. So before we end this keto on the couch, we wanted to show you something that we got.
We got something.
We picked this up at Bed Bath & Beyond.
It's on somebody's list for Christmas.
We bought three of them. I'm gonna put it back down.
It's heavy.
We bought three of them, two of them as gifts, and the third one we're going to give away here on Two Crazy Ketos because we love you guys and we want to give back to you guys. So what we want you to do is make sure you are subscribed to the channel. I know we ask this all the time, but listen, it's free. Just go ahead and go do that. It takes 2 seconds. Head down below, hit the subscribe button if you're not subscribed already, and also hit the like button. And then more importantly, you need to hit the bell button. Because next week, during Keto on the Couch, we're going to tell you how you can win this. And I'm going to let you know, it's not our normal giveaway routine.
Uh-oh.
So make sure you watch next week's Keto on the Couch. And you're only going to know that if you've watched this one all the way through.
Woo.
Okay, so go ahead and do that. But that is going to be this week's Keto on the Couch. We thank everybody for participating. We'll be back to the normal live one next week. Again, make sure you're sharing your stories either down in the comment section or sending them to stories@twocrazyketos.com or over on our Facebook group. Now, if you like seeing videos like this, take a look at some of the videos that we have linked right over there. Also, make sure you take a look at our most recent video, which I'm going to put right over here.
But whether you head this way or you head this way, don't forget to head this way. Subscribe to our channel and click the little bell icon, and that way, every single time we upload a new video, you'll be alerted to it.
Till next week.
Bye.